So let us discuss about the method of defrosting an evaporator is being defrosted. When air is cooled below its dew point temperature, it gives up the moisture and deposit on the nearest colder surface. So the colder surface in the refrigerating area is the evaporator. Therefore, the moisture in the form of dew deposit on the surface of the evaporator. When the temperature of the evaporator falls below 0 degree centigrade, the moisture deposit on the surface of the evaporator freezes and form a coating of the frost. If this frost is not removed periodically, it acts as an insulator and retards the heat transfer rate, between the air and the evaporator, which causes the compressor to run at lower suction condition. The capacity and efficiency of the refrigerating system decreases. Thus, when an evaporator operates below 0 degree centigrade, it must be defrosted periodically for the efficient operation of the system. The various methods used for defrosting the evaporator are as follows. This is the evaporator of the fridge or refrigerator, and the air which is passing through that, if the temperature in the evaporator falls 0 degree or below 0 degree centigrade, then the air which is passing through that get frosted. That is, the water particle in the air, they are frosted and deposited on the surface of the insulator between the air and the coil. So heat transfer rate is reduced. Now the method of defrosting, that is manual defrosting method, then pressure control defrosting method, temperature control defrosting method, water defrosting method, reverse cycle defrosting method, then simple hot gas defrosting method, automatic hot gas defrosting method, then thermo bank defrosting method, and electric defrosting method. These are the various defrosting methods. A manual defrosting method. The earliest and simplest method of defrosting. In this method, either the compressor is stopped refrigerant to the evaporator in is closed until the accumulated frost or ice is melted. At that point, the compressor is started or the refrigerant valve is reopened. The method is still employed on large installation. The major drawback of this system is that it requires long period for defrosting. Now the first one is the pressure control defrosting method. We have already discussed that the accumulation of the frost on the surface of the evaporator reduces the rate of heat transfer between the air and the evaporator, which causes the compressor to run at low suction pressure. When the pressure below the predetermined value due to accumulation of frost, the pressure operated control as shown in the figure, it comes into action and stops the compressor. The control is set in such a way as to permit the coil to warm up to 0 degree centigrade and defrost before it starts. Again, the stopping and starting of the system is done automatically according to the change in pressure. Here the pressure control valve, pressure control system. Sooner the suction pressure is reduced because of the frosting of the ice in the evaporator, the compressor stops automatically. Electrical connection is there, automatically it stops. Second one, it is almost the same, only the method. Here it was pressure control, here it is the temperature control defrosting method. The temperature control defrosting method as shown is similar to that pressure control defrosting method. The accumulation of frost on the surface of the evaporator causes reduction in heat transfer rate between the air and the evaporator. Due to this, the temperature of the air passing over the coil increases. When the temperature increases above the requirement of the system, a temperature operated control comes into action and stops the compressor. The stopping and starting of the system is done. The temperature control defrost method makes it possible to maintain temperature regardless of the load variation. This method is preferred to the pressure control defrosting method for the cold location because the operation of the compressor is controlled directly by the temperature. The disadvantage of this method is that it does not assure complete defrost, especially in hot weather or other high load condition. This disadvantage may be overcome by the occasional manual defrost method. Now the next one is the manual defrost method, which is, here it is evaporator. There is three-way valve, and this three-way valve allows the hot water to go and spray on the evaporator, and one drain line is there. After the temperature is being controlled, frosting is complete, that water flows through the drain line. This is the first part, that is the supply line. Then this is the drain line through which it is coming back. Here the drain line, it is coming back, supply line, hot water is sprayed over the evaporator. The water defrosting method is a simple and economical method of defrosting the evaporator where sufficient water are considered at considerably high temperature is easily available. In this method, the low side of refrigerator is pumped down as shown in figure. It is easily available in this, as shown in the figure. This action leaves the evaporator free of liquid refrigerant before defrosting begins. Both the compressor and evaporator fan are stopped, and if there are louvers, these are closed. The three-way valve is now opened as shown in the figure. The water is sufficient quantity is supplied to the spray header above the evaporator. The water was and frost formed on the surface of the evaporator. This water is caught in the drain pan and must be drawn out through the drain line. The three-way valve is now turned to another position. This permits the removal of the water from the supply line and other drain line during the defrosting cycle. That's all.